Welcome. I hope you have an enjoyable evening. And anything else you need to say?
I don't think so.
Then we can begin. Eliza Hidden was an ill-tempered harridan of a woman. She had a hooked nose and she had piercing black eyes. She was scabby. She had a toothless slit of a mouth that enclosed a vicious tongue. Wind battered against the church tower, and the whole tower began to swing, and the bells began to sound chaotically. And then some of the masonry began to fall, and it fell onto the Kintry bell and cracked it asunder. Eliza Hidden was doing a little jig, and a malicious smile grew right across her features. And then, with a dismissive wave of her gnarled hand, she walked away. Frankly, Stephen was a bit of a rotter. He had made a solemn promise to King Henry I that when he died, his daughter, Maud, would become Queen of England, ruler. She would have been the very first queen to rule England. But when Henry died, Steve broke his promise, nipped in quick, and grabbed the crown for himself.
Now, these other tunes I have been playing were all collected in around 1910, 1900, 1920. This one was collected in 1260.
Now, the narrator of this story is a young woman. So, for the purposes of the story, you must imagine that I am a young woman. Is that hard to do? I am the man who slayed a dreadful dragon. I climbed that hill with my sword, and I withstood the fiery breath, and I killed that loathly worm with a single stroke. It was terrible. I couldn't bear to listen. Nobody would listen to my story. But now you know the true story, because his story is the one that has been told ever since, how King George killed the dragon on Dragon Hill. But my story is the true story. The other story is pure evil.